Hey, fellow beauty finders, what's up? It's Matthias Allen, and I'm here with at Epic Makeup Melissa Street.
Hi, everybody.
She's back on another one of my Monday makeup chats because she is just such a wealth of information. I had to have her back. I'm so glad that you're sitting down with me on the couch.
Thank you. I'm so glad to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
I've been a fan of yours forever on Periscope. If you guys aren't following her on Periscope, you need to follow her. She's a great mentor. She's got tons of information about how to work in the business. She even takes the camera to set with her into the makeup room, which is great because that's what I like to do on my YouTube channel as well whenever I have the chance to.
Yeah.
So on this Monday Makeup Chat, we're going to talk about the difference between doing makeup for skin that's a little bit older and doing skin that is a little bit younger.
Yeah.
There are some do's and don'ts, right?
Yes, because you can get away with a lot more when you're working with someone who has younger skin that has more elasticity.
That's the word I was going to use.
Yeah, that's just, you know, like baby skin, right? You can get away with a lot more than that. You can get away with a lot more because you don't have to put on so much unless you want to. And you don't have to worry about so much correction. There's not a lot of color correction. There's not a lot of dark circles that need to be covered up. There's not a lot of age spots.
Yeah.
Sun damage, you know, so there's all that kind of stuff. This is a good thing for mature skin. So it's something that stays on longer. You don't have to keep going in and powdering, because that's the last thing you want to do is keep powdering mature skin.
Is there a certain powder that you like best?
I do.
Or a certain technique?
There is. I actually will try to stay out of the outer parts of the skin and just do the T-zones, because I think that women who have a little bit of a supple glow, when we look younger that way, right?
Yes, I agree.
So I moisturize really well, stay in the T-zone with powder. And I like to use the Orlan product. Orlan has a beautiful, beautiful setting powder, loose powder. It's finely milled, and I for mature skin, it's just primo.
Does it come in different colors?
No, it comes in like one universal color. I also like Laura Mercier. Laura Mercier's Secret Brightening Powder, but you gotta be careful with that if you're taking flash.
Yes, because there's shimmer in it. There's a little bit of shimmer.
Yeah, but it does look good on mature skin, just absolutely gorgeous on mature skin.
So I saw you use that in your scope the other
day. Yes, if you're an everyday consumer out there, makeup enthusiast, and you just want something that's beautiful, you know, for yourself, just remember, if you're taking a selfie and it's flashing, that can be a little bit of flashback there. Make sure you're really doing it nice. Don't put it under your eyes.
Now, what about concealing and concealer and things? Because I know women are always so afraid of too much product under their eye or too much powder under their eye. But I always find that it's a catch-22 because women tend to look darker as they get older,
That's true.
Because the skin is thinner, it's thinned out, you're 40 or 50, so all the blue blood is returning from your brain back into your heart, so you've got all these dark circles.
Right.
So you need to put more product, and then in order for it to not crease or have all that cream get crepey, you have to set it. So there's this really fine line.
There is a fine line with
What's your secret? That's why you're here.
So my secret is to do something more into the color correction instead of so much concealer on top of concealer on top of concealer. So get your color correction down. So, and that's where color theory comes in. The blue tones that come in there, when you think about the color wheel, what color cuts what color on the color wheel? So blue, orange cuts blue. So you wanna get into a concealer-ish or a color corrector-ish that's got more of that orangey tone, peachy tone, salmon-y tone colors in there. And that I would do that more, and then just slightly put the foundation up in there instead of a concealer.
Got
and
it.
see if that helps, okay? Do the color correction first, because we always say foundation first and then concealer. Well, this isn't concealer, this is color correction. So
right.
Do your color correction first, then do your foundation, and then see if you need to add a little bit more. But that color correction can cut down how much product you keep putting on top of it.
That's a great tip. That's
Something like that. That's where color correction is gonna come in, I think, a little bit when you get more mature.
So would you say on yourself, when you're getting ready, do you skip concealer and do that process?
I do, I go into a color correction.
You do?
I do. Yeah, I do. And I still, and to be honest with you guys, listen, I like the realness of skin. I like my age. I'm okay with it.
That's where we differ.
Yeah.
I just like a full, perfect, flawless face. Well, so I don't care how much is on it.
I actually...
on me. Okay, so last question about mature skin. Is there a technique that you like to apply foundation on that's best for mature skin? Meaning fingertips versus foundation brush versus... sponge.
Okay.
What's your favorite?
I do like the Beauty Blender, and I'll tell you why. as women get older, we do tend to get little bit of hairs and things like that, and your brush will catch those hairs. So I try to do a beauty blender and a damp beauty blender, not dripping wet, but I like to put a silicone foundation, which is, silicone's your friend when you get older. And I like to put it on with a beauty blender, and it just goes on flawlessly. So I find that's a great tool. That was in Rianne Silva knocked it out.
Yes.
She invented that beauty blender. Absolutely amazing.
I have to show you the Easom Beauty Sponge. Have you seen the Easom Beauty Sponge?
No! You have to show me something new. I would love to see that.
Okay, so I just want to share this with you. This is the Easom Pro Finishing Sponge.
Wow.
It's very similar to the beauty blender, but I love the way that it's been cut.
Yeah!
Yes.
I've never seen this before. Oh, Easom,
really cool,
and Easom makes really great brushes.
Yes.
That I know.
Yes.
Okay, this is interesting.
So
I
this
try
just
this.
Came out over the summer. It's fantastic. You can keep it.
Oh, Mom.
Please keep it. Yes, I want you to keep it. I want you to play with it. It's gorgeous.
No. Okay.
Ta-da! No, I really love it. I love it because the point of it is just like the beauty blender.
Yeah.
You can get up in here, and if you do a full coverage and you want to hit the forehead, you can use this just like the beauty blender.
Yeah.
But you have that flat surface
here,
so you can like buff and roll and buff and roll.
So nice.
Yeah.
Okay, I like that actually. And you can use it wet or dry.
Of course.
Or wet, preferred. Damp.
I've even, of course. Okay. I've even applied powder with it.
Yeah,
you know, younger skin.
No, that's fantastic because that good edge,
exactly.
That's perfect.
You can like literally put the powder
into
the skin.
I love that.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna look at that. That's fantastic. Yay, thank you for showing me. This
You're
is
welcome.
Awesome. This would be great for mature skin, you guys. This would be great with your setting powders.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I love it. I'm gonna use it.
All right, so you guys have got to stay tuned to my Monday Makeup Chat series because Melissa Street will be back very, very, very shortly. We have a couple more topics that we're going to be going over. I have some more questions. I hope you can
Sure,
stay.
Yes, of course.
Okay, good.
Absolutely,
good.
I would love to.
And if you guys aren't following her on Periscope, please, please, please do. She is a great mentor to young makeup artists and women of all ages. She's got some great techniques for doing makeup. And follow her on Periscope. Follow me as well. We both like to take our cameras behind the scenes.
Absolutely.
To set. So I'm going to put all of our social media tags down at the bottom in the description box. And thank you guys for watching. And stay tuned for two more video recommendations right after the break. All right?
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for watching my video, you guys. I hope you can stay with me because I am a working makeup artist in Los Angeles. And I have clients of all nationalities, all ages, and all types. And I want to share with you step by step the different ways that I use makeup and hair and glamour and transformation to create stunning looks for the red carpet or for family events and get-togethers. So stick with me and I'll share those with you in the weeks and days to come.